In this video, we discuss about the factors affecting rate of chemical reaction. So this will be the final video of chemical kinetics. Let me see the what are the factors we are having. So the first factor, if you observe here, concentration or pressure. So this already we discussed here, effect of concentration and the pressure. Second will be the nature of the reactant. And third will be temperature, fourth will be light, fifth will be catalyst here. So these are the factors actually. So in this concentration of the reactant, let me see first of all, concentration of reactant or pressure. Because if they are gases, we take pressure. If they are liquids, aqueous solution, we'll take concentration. So when you have more amount of reactants, the rate of reaction also will be more. That means the rate of reaction is directly proportional to what here? Concentration of reactants here. So rate of reaction, isn't it? Dx by dt. Dx by dt is the rate of reaction, which is directly proportional to concentration of what? Reactants. This is the expression we are going to get. Next, higher the reactant concentration leads to high chance of collusion. When you have more number of molecules are there, when you have more concentration, you will have more number of molecules. So more molecules are there, what happen? More collision takes place between the molecules, which leads to what? High rate of reaction. So for example, in terms of pressure, if you observe here, so when you have less low concentration is there, so collisions are very few actually. High concentration, when you have here, more collisions will take place. When more collision takes place, what happens? It leads to more pressure actually. It leads to what? More pressure. Less collisions means leads to what? Less pressure actually, isn't it? So in this way, we can easily explain actually. Next, nature of reactant. So it depends upon the surface area. When, if you see something, what happens? This is having more surface area. The surface area here is more because more surface exposed to the environment is having less surface area here. So when you have less surface area, what happens? The rate of reaction will less here. So larger the surface area of the reactants, the rate of the reaction will be more here. So here rate will be more. Okay, that is the reason finely divided reactants definitely will give more amount of rate of reaction. Next, temperature. This is the very, very important. Generally, when you increase the temperature, the rate of reaction becomes increases. So how it will take care? So when you increase the temperature, rate of reaction also increases. It is directly proportional. Temperature is directly proportional to what? Rate of reaction. Directly proportional to rate of reaction here. Next, so I have taken here some reaction is taking place. It's a reaction mixture. It is a reaction mixture. So I'm heating this one. So when you heat, what happen? More kinetic energy, because when you heat, what happen? They will move very fast. Because of this, what happen? They will get more kinetic energy. They move very, very fast. So because of this, what happen? More collisions will takes place here, isn't it? So we are going to get more number of collisions here, right? More collisions means what happen at high temperature? Then when you compare, more collisions are successful, because when you have more collisions, what happen? More chance of getting what? Reaction. Therefore, at compared to low temperature, at high temperature, collisions are more, and more amount of product also will be formed actually. So when you increase what temperature by 10 degrees Celsius, for every 10 degrees Celsius, the rate of reaction almost becomes double. For example, the rate of reaction is something what happened, dx by dt, rate of reaction, something what happened, point, something you take 2 into 10 to the power of minus 2. Okay, now this is at what? 10 degrees Celsius. Okay, now when you increase this one into 20 degrees Celsius, then it becomes 2 into 0.2 into 10 to the power of minus 2. That means for every 10 degrees Celsius, it becomes double actually. So this is the effect of temperature here. Next, temperature coefficient means how much it is increasing. The rate of reaction is how much increasing. That if you observe here, what happened? Rate constant at T temperature, a rate constant at plus 10 degrees Celsius. I told in the previous videos, rate constant does not depend upon any factor, but depends upon temperature and catalyst here. So when you change the temperature, rate constant becomes here also double here. So So rate constant, for example, here at T degrees Celsius, rate constant will be K. Then for increasing 10 degrees Celsius, it becomes what? 2K. Now KK get cancelled, temperature coefficient will be 2. That means for every 10 degrees Celsius, rate constant increases how much? 2 times here. Right? Now, let me see what is this diagram here. So I have taken your reactants, here I have taken the products here. With respect to time, reactants and products are taken. Now this is actually energy, potential energy you have taken, nothing but energy. Initially the reactant is having this much amount of energy. Now to convert these reactants into products here, this is want to convert into product like this here. Directly it never converts into products here. So this reactant should reach an energy barrier here. This is called what? Threshold energy. Threshold energy, we call this one. Now, if the reactant want to convert into product, compulsory, the reactant should reach threshold energy. So those reactant molecules which not reach threshold energy, they don't form any product. So for example, 100 molecules are there. Out of 100, only 50 molecules are reaching here. What? Towards threshold energy. Then we get 50 molecules will convert into product here. Isn't it? Only 50 molecules will convert into product. Remaining 50, they don't convert into product. They remain as reactants only. Why? Because the remaining 50, they didn't reach the threshold energy here. Okay? That is the main thing actually. Now, important next thing is what? Now, the energy difference between energy of the reactant, this is the energy of the reactant, and this one is the threshold energy, isn't it? Threshold energy it is. Threshold energy. Okay. The difference between the, isn't it? Threshold energy and energy of the reactant always equal to activation energy. Always equal to activation energy. Now what is the activation energy? The difference between threshold energy and energy of a reactant is called activation energy. Otherwise, the energy is required by the reactant. The energy is required by the reactant to give the product. That energy is called what? Activation energy. So the minimum energy required by a reactant to initiate the chemical reactions is nothing but called what? Activation energy. That is represented by what? EA, isn't it? So for any molecule to give the product, you need that need to reach threshold energy. Right? Next. We'll see some MCQs. At high concentration of reactant, the reaction goes very fast, right? Definitely it will be very fast here. Next. Concentration of reactant has no effect on rate of reaction. Is it correct? No. Concentration of reactant will have an effect. It is directly proportional to what? Rate of reaction. Temperature affects rate because, what is the reason? Molecules get more energy. When you increase the temperature, collisions will increase, molecules will get more energy. Next. Rate of reaction directly proportional to amount of the reactant, temperature, size of the vessel, all of the above. Which one we can take here? Rate of reaction is directly proportional to what? Isn't it? Temperature. If you increase the temperature, rate of reaction will increases. And what about this one? Amount of the reactant also will increases. See, when you take more amount of reactant concentration, rate of reaction will increase. So the answer will be all of the above. This is not correct. Okay. All of the above is the correct answer. Next. On increasing temperature, the kinetic energy of reactant generally what happen? Increases. Kinetic energy directly proportional to what? Temperature, no. It is directly proportional to temperature. So answer will be increases here. Next. For every 10 degrees Celsius, rate of reaction becomes definitely doubles, right? Next. What about the effect of catalyst? So catalyst means the substance which alters the rate of reaction but does not consume in the reaction. That means that will unchange in the reaction. That is called what? Catalyst. So alter means some catalyst may increase the rate of reaction. They are called positive catalyst. Some catalyst, they decrease the rate of reaction. They are called what? Negative catalyst. Here. So two type of catalysts are there. So definition is which alters the rate of reaction without consuming in the reaction. They are called catalyst. Here. So generally a catalyst will provide an alternate pathway it will provide. What is this alternate pathway? Let me take with a diagram. Actually, I have taken x-axis, I have taken y-axis. Then on x-axis I have taken reaction coordinate, means nothing but reactant at first time, worked at last. Then on the y-axis I have taken energy, potential energy I have taken here. Next, at first we are going to have reactant, and at last we are going to have product here. Okay, with respect to time, reactant will convert into product like this. Now, so for every reactant, if you want to convert into product, this reactant must reach what? Threshold energy, isn't it? This, for example, this is a reactant. Okay, want to convert into what? Product here. It want to convert into product here. In this, it want to convert into product like this. So in that case, definitely this should what? Reach what? Threshold energy. Should reach what? Threshold energy. If it reach threshold energy only, you're going to get the product actually, isn't it? Now, so what is happening here? If I don't take the catalyst, I need to take in the catalyst. So the reactant is converted into product by reaching what here? This threshold energy. But the threshold energy, if you observe here, what is happening here? Let me see here. Threshold energy, if you observe here, this is the threshold energy. What is the threshold energy here? The energy difference, energy of the reactant, threshold energy, isn't it? Threshold energy, otherwise ET. Now, what is activation energy is equal to threshold energy? Threshold energy minus energy of reactant. Now, when you observe here, activation energy from here, if you observe what happened, it is what? More, very high compared to here. Here to here, what happened is very high. Okay, this is what? Very high. Very high. Now, if I use catalyst, what happened? If I use catalyst, now reaction proceeds in different path. Now, this is proceeding in which path? Different path like this. This is proceeding in different path like this. In this way, it is proceeding like this. When you observe here in this case, what is the activation energy? Now, for this one, this will be the threshold energy. This will be the threshold energy, isn't it? Now, in the case of this one, activation energy will be, again, threshold energy minus energy of reactant. Here, you are getting how much value here? Very less here. This value will be very less. This will be less. That means when you use the catalyst, the reaction proceeds in different path compared to this path. Previously, it is proceeding in this path actually. But now it will proceed in this path. Now, because of this, what happened? When you use catalyst, threshold energy, isn't it? Threshold energy will be decreased. Okay. And activation energy also will be decreased here. So that is the reason what happened. Just now we see in this one, no? The previous slide. See, a catalyst provides an alternate pathway of lower activation energy. Showing what? Alternate pathway with lower activation energy. Now you observe here what happened here. You are going to see this one, isn't it? So this is the what actually? Without catalyst. So without catalyst, isn't it? What has happened here, you see? It is moving, isn't it? With reaching this short threshold energy, see? It is moving like this. Without catalyst. So it should reach what? This threshold energy to give the product here. Okay. Now if I use catalyst, what happened? If I use catalyst here, what happened? Now we are going to get, see. Now it is moving with less threshold. It is easy, no? Very simple, no? You observe again. It is moving what? Very simple. Now it is reaching this threshold energy, very less threshold energy. Activation energy also, but very less it required, giving the product here. So this is happening with respect to catalyst actually. See, the threshold energy here, how much you are getting? More. Threshold energy is more. This one is more. Activation energy is more. Threshold energy is more. Therefore, in this case, the rate of reaction will be less here. Okay. This will be energy of activation without catalyst is what? More actually, isn't it? Without catalyst is more actually, isn't it? Let me clear this one. Now, energy of activation is what? Without catalyst is what here? Very high here. Next, when you observe here, now energy of activation is how much here? In this case here, energy of activation is very less. Energy of activation with catalyst is what? Less here, isn't it? So this is about the effect of catalyst. Now we'll take some MCQs here. A catalyst is a substance that lowers the, which one it will lowers here? Activation energy. Next, which of the following will provide an alternate path with the lower activation energy? Definitely what happened? Catalyst. Next, this will be the, this is about the topics we discussed in this video. Effect of catalyst, effect of temperature. Still we have actually Arrhenius equation is there, collision is theory is there, but these are deleted. They reduce the syllabus. So deleted what? Activation energy and collision theory. So with this what happened? Chemical kinetics completed here.